you can tell a lot about a VPN company, not only by the copy on their website, but also to a lesser degree by the way that they brand themselves. So instead of focusing on cute bears, or I don't even know what this character's supposed to be, ProtonVPN and the rest of the Proton products are laser focused on privacy. And here's the problem. I don't think that traditional VPNs are great privacy tools. Then again, I would argue that ProtonVPN isn't entirely a virtual private network. Welcome to All Things Secured. My name's Josh, and today I'm gonna give you an overview of the ProtonVPN software, both the free and the premium product. But more importantly, I wanna explain what it is about the product and the company itself that gives me more confidence in their ability to deliver on the promise of privacy and security. See, I've been using VPNs for more than a decade now, and I can tell you that a lot of what I see is simply a combination of clever marketing and consumer confusion about how virtual private networks and even more broadly, the internet works. Because to be honest, a VPN wasn't initially designed to be a privacy tool. Strictly speaking, a VPN is a way to create a secure, encrypted connection between two points on a public network. And that's exactly what most commercial VPNs, including the free version of ProtonVPN, do. As you can see here, the free version of ProtonVPN gives me the ability to create an encrypted connection between servers in the United States, the Netherlands, and in Japan. These are free, so you'll notice most of these servers have a high load, and that's indicated by that yellow or red circle you see here on the left. This means that there's a lot of people connected to that server, and it will likely be a slow connection. Any other servers or advanced features such as Secure Core or NetShield, which I'll explain in a moment, those require an upgrade to the premium service. However, if you simply want to evade censorship or hide your IP address, the free version of ProtonVPN allows you to do just that. You won't be able to stream geo-blocked content, you know, stuff like Netflix or Disney Plus, and your internet speeds will likely be pretty slow, but that's what you get with any type of free product, especially free VPNs. One thing I don't like is that when upgrading, Proton gives you an unnecessarily confusing list of packages to choose from. The basic package simply unlocks the faster servers, allows peer-to-peer file sharing, and offers two simultaneous connections. The visionary package, on the other hand, gives you this whole Proton Mail account, which is a secure email that I personally use and really like, but you can get a separate Proton Mail account for much, much cheaper. I mean, they even have a free version available. So honestly, I don't see why most people would want a visionary account. So what I'm going to be focusing on here is what they currently call the Plus account. This can be purchased at a discount if you spring for 1 or 2 years. And although it's not very clear on the sales page, their terms and conditions state that they offer a 30-day money-back guarantee. Now, let me quickly show you how the premium version compares to the free now that I've upgraded. But stay with me because I'm going to explain what it is about the ProtonVPN Plus version that deviates from what most commercial VPNs offer. All right off the bat, you'll see that all the advanced features have been unlocked, which I promise I'll explain soon. Likewise, you'll notice that I have access to every available server in their network, which currently includes, I think, over 1,000 servers in 55 different countries. There are other VPN companies that boast a lot more server options, but the truth is that as long as my connection is fast, with low server load, the only thing that really matters is the country option. And servers in 55 countries covers more than what you'll probably need. Oh, and one quick note on a feature I wish was different with ProtonVPN. Right now on my Mac computer, I don't have the ability to change connection protocols, which it's weird to me since pretty much every other VPN software can do that on a Mac, so I know it's possible. Now I can do it on other platforms, including my iPhone, but protocols are limited to only IKEV2 and OpenVPN. Don't get me wrong, both of these are strong encryption protocols, but you won't find the newer WireGuard protocol, which is being adopted by most other VPN companies due to the fact that it has lightweight code, faster speeds, and a stable connection. Now, at the beginning of this review, I hinted at the idea that ProtonVPN offers privacy because it doesn't always act like a VPN. Well, what do I mean by that? There are two key features that ProtonVPN offers here that build on this idea of a relay network, meaning that your data is passed through multiple servers before reaching its final destination. This makes it much harder, although not impossible, for somebody to track your data across the internet. The first is what Proton calls Secure Core. Secure Core offers greater privacy than a regular VPN connection by first routing your traffic through one of their protected data centers in Switzerland, Iceland, or Sweden. Your connection is then routed from there through any other country you want, providing that extra layer of privacy. It's very similar to what other VPN companies call a double hop VPN, except with a slightly greater level of security. But as I say with any VPN review I do on this All Things Secured channel, security and privacy are a product of trust. And there's always risk when you're trusting a centralized network provider, even ProtonVPN. The difference with Proton that I find intriguing is that besides providing independent audits and no logs policies, which every single VPN service is now claiming, they're one of the only commercial VPNs that I'm aware of, at least, that publishes the code of all of their apps as open source for scrutiny. This means that you or a security researcher can literally log on to GitHub and look through the code of each platform app to make sure it's as secure as they say it is. Now, when you combine that with the fact that both their CEO and CTO have PhDs and attended Harvard and Stanford, they've done a pretty good job of instilling confidence in their people and their commitment to privacy. They're not hiding behind some veil of anonymity that most of these VPN companies tend to do. But let's say that you're super paranoid, and even the idea of giving your data to a relatively trustworthy company like Proton is just too much for you. Well, that's where this second privacy feature called Tor Over VPN comes into play. I've already discussed the differences between Tor and VPN in another video that I recommend you watch next. But the key takeaway is that they each offer different services that, when combined, build an even better privacy tool. You can look for these Tor servers that have the onion icon on the left here, or as I prefer to do, ProtonVPN gives me the ability to create different profiles. You can see here that I've created one for watching Disney Plus that connects me to the fastest US server, and then I've created a Tor connection that I can easily activate. When activated, I'm now using ProtonVPN to establish an encrypted connection to a server in France that then routes me through all the Tor network of random nodes all around the world, those that even Proton doesn't know about. It's a slower connection, but it overcomes that hurdle of a centralized network when you absolutely need it. And unlike regular Tor, which for most people only protects data that's sent through a specific Tor browser, this ProtonVPN Tor connection privatizes all of the data your device sends through the internet. All right, let me finish with a rapid fire pros and cons list in case you're still on the fence about ProtonVPN. First, on the pros side, they give you 5 simultaneous connections with the Plus plan, which is really standard across the industry. They have a VPN kill switch, DNS leak protection, open source apps, live chat support, and a very transparent company structure, which is somewhat unique in the industry. I also consider it a benefit that they've built a great secure email product that complements the VPN service. You can even sign up for a free ProtonMail email and use that as an anonymous way to create your ProtonVPN account. On the con side, they don't offer the WireGuard protocol as an option. They haven't developed apps for Chromebooks, smart TVs, or media streaming devices, and they don't have other advanced features such as split tunneling, which only encrypts select data on your device. Overall though, and I don't say this very often, if privacy is a concern for you and you have to trust a centralized entity to provide this privacy and security, I really like Proton, both the company and the product. And there's no good reason not to try them since they have free versions of both their VPN and mail service. Use the link in the description below to download the software and try it today. And if this video has been helpful to you as you've been researching your decision of whether or not to use ProtonVPN, please hit that like button because it allows me to create even more content to help you keep all things secured.